Hello, and viewers, it's me, Obona Thanamatovu here at KISA Projects. Remember, KISA Projects is a home for entrepreneurs located here in Komamboga or Kumukaaga along Gayaza Road. We are always open for business Monday to Saturday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. Today, I'm here basically to talk about the soap production science, or the science behind quite around the bus soap production, and briefly about the soap manufacturing business. To begin with, soap is a salt of fatty acids. However, that salt of fatty acids must be achieved through a chemical process known as saponification. Soap is a salt of fatty acids achieved through a chemical process known as saponification. In general terms, saponification refers to the grouping of a strong alkaline solution with fatty acids to form a salt. Remember, I've just said that soap is a salt of fatty acids. So when I say to form a salt, I mean to form soap. Now, since that we know what's meant by soap, which is a salt of fatty acids, and we know the process that we have to undergo through for us to come up with that salt of fatty acids, which is saponification. I've said saponification is the grouping of a strong alkaline solution with fatty acid to form a salt. Now, in defining saponification, we have two key words: a strong alkaline solution and fatty acids. A strong alkaline solution will determine the type of salt that we are going to manufacture, because we have two types of salts. There's what we call the sodium salt and the potassium salt. The sodium salts are soaps manufactured using sodium hydroxide, and those soaps tend to remain either solid or powdered in nature. Either solid or powdered form in nature. And on the other hand, potassium salts are soaps manufactured using potassium hydroxide, and they will remain either liquid or soft in nature. However, my essence today to stand before the camera right now is to talk about the sodium salt. So when we get sodium hydroxide, which must be used for us to manufacture sodium salt, and we group it with fatty acids, we shall come up with a sodium salt. Now the question comes, what are fatty acids? Fatty acids are carboxylic acids of long aliphatic chains, some being saturated and some being unsaturated. The fatty acids must be 8 in number, 4 of them being saturated and 4 of them being unsaturated. These fatty acids will contribute to the 5 qualities of a good bar of soap. And the qualities of a good bar of soap are hardiness, cleansing, and bubbly lather. Hardiness, cleansing, and bubbly lather, we shall get them from the saturated fatty acids. Then the other two qualities, we have conditioning and creamy lather. And those ones, we shall get them from the unsaturated fatty acids. The unsaturated fatty acids are ricinoleic, oleic, linoleic, and linolenic. And then the saturated fatty acids are myrcetic, palmitic, stearic, lauric. Myrcetic, palmitic, stearic, and lauric. So these saturated fatty acids will contribute to the hardiness of a soap. A good bar of soap should be strong, mild, and durable. In front of me, I have a soap sample. Let us have a look at it right now as we are proceeding with our theoretical session. However, this video is not intended to train you how to manufacture high-end quality soap. However, it is intended to give you basics on how quality soap must be produced. However, if you're interested in our trainings, you can come here at KISA Projects for training. We're always open Monday, Saturday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. And our training fees just Ghana shillings 150,000. However, those who are interested in our kits, we have soap production kits of 1.9. When you buy that kit of 1.9, you have to go further and pay an extra fee of 250,000 Ghana shillings for training and train you for 3 days. Or you can decide to buy our kit of Ghana shillings 3 million and still we shall train you for 3 days in the course of training with that kit. And all equipment used in the course of production shall belong to you. Let us have a look at our sample soap here as we are discussing or describing the qualities of a good bar of soap. Here is my sample bar of soap. We manufactured it yesterday, so we had to wait for it to get chewed. So I have to remove these covers so that will remain with the soap itself. So let me unmold the soap. So what do we mean by hardiness? A good bar of soap should be hard. You can feel that soap is hard. However, it has some sort of mildness into it. When I had tried to overcompress it, I feel that it has some kind of softness into it. That's what we call mild, and it should be durable. It should not vary in size after a certain period of time, provided I have not used it. For instance, if I put it on the weighing scale and maybe it is weighing, let's say 1,500 grams, even if I don't use it, even if I leave it like this for a period of, let's say, 1 year and I come back, it should still remain weighing 1,500 grams. If it decreases in size by any chance, it means there's something wrong I did with my production. So, hence, that defines the hardiness, whereby a good bar of soap should be strong, mild, and durable. That's what we mean by hardiness. Then, quite number two, we have cleansing. Cleansing refers to the ability of the soap to remove oil materials or greasy substances from the areas of application, or the ability of the soap to trap dirt and lose it away from the wash solution. Cleansing also goes from the saturated fatty acid that we shall use to use, that we shall choose to use in the course of manufacturing soap. To make you remember, my name is Nathan Matovu. I know we have a big audience as KISA Projects, and most of our people, they are local people based here in our country of residence, Uganda. Most of people have been coming to our inbox and requesting us to do some videos in a Luganda secession. However, I'll use English, but I'll mix in some bit of Luganda today. English will work out especially for the international market, people outside our boundaries of our country, Uganda. However, other people outside Uganda refer to the English version of this video. So we have talked of hardiness, we have talked of cleansing, there's also bubbly. Bubbly measures the cleansing abilities of the soap. We shall see bubbly when we try to put this soap under use. In front of me here, I have a soap bar table cutting machine, Amilas treated. So I'm going to use this soap bar table cutting machine to resize this bar of soap to accurately 1 bar of soap weighing 1 kilogram. Then the wastage or the offcut I'll get off this soap, I'll use it to test the quality of the soap so that you can clearly watch whether you have all the 5 qualities of a good bar of soap with our sample here today. Then eventually, the bar of soap that I will size to accurate 1 kilogram, I'll have to stamp onto it using a table roller stamp. In front of me here, I have most of the tools and equipments and machineries needed in soap production. Let's talk about each of them and their function and their prices. Let me first put my soap here, and then we start by seeing each of these equipment needed in soap production and their function. Hope you are enjoying this video. We are KISA Projects, a home for entrepreneurs, and with us, no one can be too young to own a company. We are located in Komamboga, Kumukaaga, along Gayaza Road. Interested in talking to us, you can give us a call on +256 752 492 194 or +256 7795 93452 or +256 702 756 107. To begin with, let's have a look at the hydrometer, Twaddle hydrometer. This is the Twaddle hydrometer. A Twaddle hydrometer will be used to measure the specific gravity of the strong alkaline solution. And the right specific gravity can be defined based on the temperature in degrees Fahrenheit of the strong alkaline solution that you are using, based on the amounts and your formula. Inside this Twaddle hydrometer, I have a Twaddle scale. These are Twaddle hydrometers. So I want to be clear in each and everything that I'm explaining to you right now. I'm going to get one of my Twaddle hydrometers and I break it so that we can see its composition inside, so that I can clearly give you the function of the Twaddle hydrometer. A Twaddle hydrometer or a Twaddle scale is a simplified scale based on specific gravity, where 0 degree Twaddle equates to specific gravity 60 or 60 degrees Fahrenheit of 1.00, that of water. And each degree Twaddle equals to 0.005. I want you to understand me very well when it comes to this definition. Most people, they are manufacturing soap, but they are just gambling with how to use the Twaddle hydrometer. We are not certain, and even you don't know exactly what the use of a Twaddle hydrometer in soap production. Listen to me very well. A Twaddle hydrometer or a Twaddle scale is a simplified scale based on the specific gravity, where 0 degree Twaddle equates to specific gravity 60 or 60 degrees Fahrenheit of 1.00 that of water, and each degree Twaddle is equivalent to 0.005. So I want to get one of my hydrometers. Then I'm going to destroy it so that we can see this Twaddle scale very well and we understand it exactly very well. So that if we're there manufacturing soap but just gambling, not knowing exactly what you are doing today, this lesson is for you. However, if you fail to understand this, then come here for training and we show you how everything should be done right. We are the KISA Projects, a home for entrepreneurs, and with us, no one can be too young to own a company. Our interest is to show you how to do things right, coming up with quality. Remember, value for money will help you sell out. So make sure you're manufacturing quality products so that you can keep getting a big bunch of customers flowing to your room to come and support you. Let's see the inside part of this Twaddle hydrometer. So I get my hydrometer. To avoid accidents, let me first put the plastic bag here. So this is the Twaddle scale that I was talking of. So it's try to destroy it. This one's here pass to measure the specific gravity. I'm doing this for the sake of helping you understand everything very well. Oh shit. Yes, sorry about that word. So not to make me laugh now. We are sorry about these laughters. Let me destroy this. Sorry. So inside here, yeah, you can see closely. Inside here, I probably don't get any accident with this. Perfect. So inside here, we have a Twaddle scale. Okay, now that we have it clearly. So here on the scale, they give us the Twaddle readings. However, in actual practicals, when manufacturing soap, we don't target these Twaddle readings. We target the temperature at which we use the Twaddle hydrometer into the strong alkaline solution. So let's say, provided I want to use my Twaddle hydrometer, this is the Twaddle hydrometer. I've just destroyed it to help you show the Twaddle scale of it. So if I want to use my Twaddle hydrometer, let's say at 52 degrees Fahrenheit. If I wanted to use it at 62 degrees Fahrenheit, they have told us that each degree Twaddle is equivalent to 0.005. Okay, let's say I want to use the Twaddle hydrometer at 55 degrees Fahrenheit. They have told us that each degree Twaddle is equivalent to 0.005. However, 0 degree Twaddle is 0 degree Twaddle equates to 0 degree Twaddle equates to 60 degrees Fahrenheit or specific gravity 60 SG 60 of 1.00 that of water. So which means if you want to understand 55 degrees to Twaddle readings, the formula will be 55 times 0.005 plus 1. Get your calculator and try to do it with me. 55 times 0.005 plus 1. So we shall end up getting 1.275. So which means in that instance, we shall use our Twaddle hydrometer at 1.275. Provided we are using it in the strong alkaline solution in the given quantities at 55 degrees Fahrenheit. Hope I'm clear with that. Nothing more to talk about the Twaddle hydrometer. Let's go to another equipment. That's it about the Twaddle hydrometer. You must be having one if at all you're manufacturing soap. However, it's not a must that you should use it in your soap production. Not the function of it, so just only use it where necessary. Just use it only where necessary. Get it here at KISA Projects at just a few of Ugandan shillings, 100,000 Ugandan shillings. Get it here at KISA Projects at a few of Ugandan shillings, 100,000 Ugandan shillings. Kafuna wano KISA projects tukatunda emitwaro 10. So that is enough about the Twadrom hydrometer. Let's go to machine number 2, equipment number 2 that we shall need in soap production. We shall need a top loading digital weighing scale. We have these ones in different capacities based on the loads they can handle at once, or the maximum loading capacity. For instance, the one I'm having here can read up to 40,000 grams at once, and you can get it here at KISA Project at a few Ugandan shillings, 400,000 Ugandan shillings. However, we have also other cheaper options. We have a digital scale that can read up to 5,000 grams at a few Ugandan shillings, 80,000, and one that can read up to 30,000 grams at a fee of Ugandan shillings, 300,000. Let's see how effectively you have to use a digital scale in soap production. This video is here to help you master everything you need in soap production. However, for training on how to manufacture high-end quality soap, you must come here at KISA Projects and learn with us. We are here to help make it happen for you, how to use a digital scale. Keep watching. Here we have our digital scale. It has the front and the back screen. So it has its power button underneath here. Hope it is seen clearly. Its power button is underneath here. So when I press this, even you see here, on stroke of, this is the power button. So it means when I press this button, this side, like this, it goes on. When I press it like this, it goes off. So the power button of this scale is here. Let's put it on. When I press it on, watch closely on the screen. First of all, it shows me very many digits, and eventually it gives me zero. Let me switch it off again, and I switch it on so that we can see closely the screen while it displays. So we do it once again, press it on, watch on the screen. First of all, it shows me very many digits, then eventually it will give me zero. Here it's showing me 0.000. So it means the first zero is the kilogram. Then the rest of the three zeros are the grams. For instance, when I get my book and I press it on top, it means the book is weighing 0 kilograms and 510 grams. If I get anything and I add it on top, so the book combined with the soap all together, they are weighing 1 kilogram 765 grams. If I happen to add anything on top still, let me also add another book. So it means now we have gone to 1 kilogram 860 grams. However, if I remove all these, and maybe I put something with less weight, it means this one alone is weighing 0 kilograms, 095 grams, or it's just weighing 95 grams. The same measurement will give you here, it's the same measurement it will give you at the back screen. So it is a standard weighing scale and it is accurate. Even if I try to press on it, the moment I leave it, it comes back to the actual measurement. Get one here at KISA Project. That's how you can use a digital scale. Thank you. So you also need a KISA Projects lecture book. KISA Project lecture book. How do they say lecture in Uganda? Ekitabo ky'okusoma. Wetaaga KISA Projects ekitabo ky'okusoma. This is a plain book. It has nothing inside. So you'll be writing your notes in this book when you come here for training. Yeah. This book, you can get it here at KISA Projects, just a few Ugandan shillings, 7,000. However, if you don't want to buy this book of Ugandan shillings, 7,000 for KISA Projects, you can come with any other book from your home, or you can come here, we sell other small books at just a few Ugandan shillings, 1,000, to help you write your notes. We also have an impulse sealing machine. This impulse sealing machine will help you to seal the pouches or the plastic bags where you pack your finished bar of soap. Get one here at KISA Projects for just a few Ugandan shillings, 250,000. Next year, I have a saponification loaf mold, Amira treated. This one we sell here at KISA Projects for just a few Ugandan shillings, 120,000. We have industrial rubber, hand gloves, industrial goggles, these are safety equipment, and the gas mask. A full set like this at a few Ugandan shillings, 32,000. You also need them. Remember, always safety
first. Yeah. You also need a scraper at a fee of Ghana shillings 15,000. Some plastic containers to help you hold your chemicals at the time of using them in soap production. And then a plastic spoon. We also need a wool cloth. A wool cloth to help us in saponifying the molded soap until when it gets completely toward in the mold at a fee of Ghana shillings 20,000. Then you have the entrepreneur's bag that you can use to wrap your soap after stamping onto it. Our minimum order quantity is 4,000 grams at a fee of Ghana shillings 120,000.
You also have an electric mixer or professional electric mixer. This is a must have if you want to manufacture high-end quality soap on large scale of production or dealing with big quantities. This one goes at a fee of Ghana shillings just 600,000. However, those who are doing it on a small scale of production or micro scale of production, we have also a margarine blender that are fee of Ghana shillings 250,000. However, this type of mixer goes for Ghana shillings 600,000, readily available here at KISA Projects and will help you to do the mixing of your soap. We also have a bleaching tank here for bleaching the fatty acid. This one you can get it here at KISA Projects at 150,000. Okay, enough of the talk. Let's just come to our soap. We slice it so that it can actually weigh 1 kilogram, and even we witness practically the 5 qualities of a good bar of soap, which are hardiness, cleansing, conditioning, bubbly lather, and creamy lather. Yo, if you need soap production, and you don't come here at KISA Projects, don't regret the outcomes or the consequences you will face in the course of manufacturing soap for commercial purposes. If it is at KISA Projects here, then you are free of any risk. Our formulas are all proven, and we assure you, or we guarantee to you, that the soap you learn from us can easily pass standards at the National Bureau of Standards. Join us here for training, Monday, Saturday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. And our training fees just vanishing 150,000. However, those who choose to buy our kit of 1.9 m, you have to pay an extra fee for training, 250,000. Or our kit of 3 million, you just come and purchase, and still we train you how to manufacture soap with that kit for 3 days. Let's test our soap and we see the final end product. Thank you. Keep watching. I remain your boy, Nathan Matov. However, I'm still here with you. So using my illustrated double cutting machine, this one you can get it here at KISA Projects at 500,000. So I subdivide my soap like that. It can accurately weigh 1 kilogram. Simple and easy, just like this. Okay, so now let me remove. This is the off cut I've cut off. We are going to use this one to test the quality of the soap. Then this is the accurately sized 1 kilogram bar of soap. Let's try to use this one and we see how it forms this one. So let me get my scraper and I try to slice it into small bars that I can use to test the quality. See? The soap looks really amazing. Those who are interested in such projects, yes, you can come here at KISA Projects for training. Just know that we know Luganda. Yeah. If you need to talk to us in Luganda, yes, you can just give us a call. Or you get all Luganda to remind you no kusinga woroza. Okay, so now I'm going to use part of these small soaps to show you how our soap forms. We already witnessed hardiness, so this is just plain water. This is just water. So this is my handkerchief in the plain water. You have witnessed that this is just plain water, nothing into it. So, this is our soap.
So there's something that we call criminalize. So when I put water on the soap, it can easily run away from my skin. So that's what we call criminalize. Creme lather. And it can easily form with bubbles. You see those bubbles? That's what we call bubble lather. And it easily forms. So let's try to use it in washing this handkerchief. So you see how the soap easily forms. We have decided to use a big batch of water or big volume of water so that we can clearly show that this soap forms easily due to its quality. So it can easily form. Imagine your mommy waka na wakwade kano kasabuni kwa gendo kwa zesengo ya oja kunyumirwa. And it doesn't vary in size easily. So it is durable enough. Look at the product. Look, when I try to put it on my skin, it forms easily. Okay, let me now wash my handkerchief. So you have seen bubbly and creamy lather.
And that's it. I've been your boy Nathan Matovu here at KISA Projects. Yeah, we are located in Komamboga, Okumukaaga, along Gaza Road, and we are always open Monday to Saturday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. Thank you for watching. Thank you for following KISA Projects. We love you. Have a nice day. Abadi na fono Uganda. Abadi na fono ngabadi interested in the Uganda secession. Obanga magalo kumanya twali tukola mu Uganda. Twali tuyigiriza. Twali tubaraga obumuko bukodyo obutonotono. Obuyinza okuyamba kukola sabuni. Owe kikugu atukaganye no mutindo. However, obuya gaddo kujja kusoma na fesolo kusomesa either mu Uganda oba muruzungu olimi lw'osobola okutegeera lwonna tusobola okusomesa n'otegeera kye tuba tuyigiriza. Namba zaffe z'essimu tulina nooti 7795342. Nooti endala nooti 7795 n'endala nooti 7529 abadde ku kamera ye Namanda Josephine jangwe n'abantu bakulabeko jake kikombo tikyo jja abantu nga bantu come decide that people can see you jangu bakasoma bakulabeko I have been the person behind the camera. She's Namanda Josephine. Thank you. Bye bye. Namanda Murugwara wa Demweru.